I read, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, that your first film was with Kate Jackson? I mean, let's go back to the Western world.
It's hilarious because what happened, it was the first MOW to be filmed.
MOW?
Movie of the week.
Okay. Yep.
In the Yukon. Huge ordeal. Yeah. You know, they were going to bring $1 million into the economy. It was all over the papers. Everyone was talking about it. You know, wow, we're getting our first movie in Whitehorse.
Cool.
Yeah, so I think I had just recently or within the year finished that music art and drama program that I talked about. Mm-hmm. And I heard about this audition, and they were doing a casting call. There was tons of parts, and they wanted to cast a bunch of local actors and what have you. So I went in, and I can't remember what I went in for. I think I went in for a reporter or something. And I ended up getting the starting line official. Which is pretty, pretty easy gig. I think I had one line, and you know, of course, I did the countdown and did the countdown a couple times and a couple lines. You know, one scene where I was kind of with Kate Jackson, and I got my own chair, which was a huge deal for me. I remember my dad; he was so funny because he was on set and he was taking pictures. And it was like, you know, the funniest thing about it is, I went traveling not soon after that. Did that for a few years of my life, so I didn't actually do another gig or get involved in acting again until I got back to Vancouver. Well, till I moved to Vancouver and started taking classes. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that was my first experience.
Wow.
It was a horrible movie, I'll be honest with you.
Well, at least you know that.
Yeah.
But still, you know, Kate Jackson, come on.
Hey, Kate Jackson, come on.
In your own hometown.
Yeah. I think a lot of Yukoners got a kick out of that movie because it's supposed to be about the Iditarod. Yeah. Which is, you know, a dog race from Whitehorse to Anchorage.
With Kate Jackson? Oh, please.
Yeah, exactly. And she had this little head warmer and this nice little Gore-Tex jacket and stuff. You understand, this is like at 40 below. The people who do these races, they lose probably about 5 dogs on the race, die. It's very rugged, very rugged race. So
then you traveled after that.
Yeah.
And came back, and then it seems like you've had a sort of a flurry of roles. You've been in Cold Squad, mm-hmm. Dark Angel. Anything that really stood out for you? Anything that was, you know, really fabulous for you? I mean, I'm sure they all work as you're building your career, right?
But. Yeah. Well, I mean, your first guest story, your first substantial role is always a big deal. Mm-hmm. You know, I thought it was a bigger deal than it was. I remember when I found out I got a guest star on Glory Days. Huh. I think it only lasted a season and a half. It was a show that was filmed up here. And some great actors on it, though. Very young cast. Poppy Montgomery, who's now on, what is it called? Missing? Is it Missing? Oh, Without a Trace.
Right.
Actually, she's one of the leads. She's the pretty blonde Australian actress. And Eddie Cahill, who's on New York CSI. So that was a huge deal for me. I remember finding out when my agent called me, and I was literally doing the victory dance and so excited. But I mean, more than anything, the gigs that really stuck out for me was Cold Squad was huge.
Yeah.
Because I was being introduced, I mean, the longest running Canadian television series.
Mm-hmm. And a good series.
A good series.
Yeah.
And they were really trying to flip the script a little bit, try something fresh and new. Brand new DOP. I love the way the last season was shot. Mm-hmm. They tried some new things. Great cast to work with. Julia Keatley, Gary Harvey, wonderful director. Matthew Bennett, very talented actor. So that was a huge deal for me. It was my first regular on a series.
Yeah.
So I was so nervous, but
pretty
so excited.
Pretty respectable role, though. That, you know, that was neat.
Yeah, it was. I was honored to get that. Mm-hmm. I remember, you know, they were casting all over Canada for that, but it was one of those things. The funny thing, a good friend of mine, Alex Ponovic, got the part, the audition for it, and I was driving him to another audition. He had two that day, and he was reading it, and he's going, because we had just been having a conversation. I'm like, when am I going to get my cop role? Like, I'm the cop guy. When am I going to get my cop role? I've been waiting for this.
Did you actually want to be a police officer at some point?
I think when I was younger, I wanted to be an RCMP officer. But I'm like, when am I going to get my cop role? And I was like, well, this is kind of perfect for you. And I looked at it, called my agent right away, and she's like, you know what? I just got this myself. I didn't even know. She's like, yes, you got to go out for this. I'll make the call. So as soon as I read it, though, it was one of those roles. I have to be honest with you. You know, two of the biggest roles that I've ended up getting in my life, I kind of knew I was going to get. Sometimes you read a part and you're like, no, this is mine.
Ah.
Or at least you're, you know, you're pretty confident that you're the right guy for the job. Or you connect to it enough that you know you've got a good chance at least. And I felt like that about Cold Squad.
Yeah. Did you feel like that about Battlestar Galactica?
Absolutely.
You did.
Minute I read it.
Isn't that interesting? I wonder if that has something to do with that whole spiritual thing that we're talking about.
It could,
you know?
And
your grandmother,
you know,
who knows?
Yeah, who knows? And you know, very much, you know, I think oftentimes you just get blessed with good writing.
Yeah.
You connect to it. You see the you know, the similarities in your own life and experiences, and automatically you'll hear actors say that a lot. Sometimes they'll read a role and they'll understand what's going on. They'll understand the character. Mm-hmm. I think that you always have to make choices and do work, but it's, sometimes you're blessed with a certain part you read and you just know.
Yeah.
So
do you project yourself into the future as an actor now, or are you taking it one day at a time still and just kind of enjoying it, or?
Yeah, you know, I mean, one thing I've tried to teach myself in the last few years of my life is I try to be present as much as I can, you know, be in the now.
Yeah. Well, we're out of time. And I'm sorry about that, because this has been, it's been great talking to you.
Yeah, thank you very much.